This is Chester Wilmot broadcasting from a glider bound for France and invasion. We're now just passing over the English coast. And from that coast, a few hours past, when the invasion barges carrying the third wave of the assault forces, the main forces which will land on the coast of France tomorrow morning. From where I am, standing between the two pilots of this glider, I can see the navigation lights of the tug in front of us, and off to left and right, the navigation lights of other tugs and other gliders bound on the same mission. Circling above from time to time, I can see the lights of the fighter screen, which is protecting us. And looking back down the glider, there are seated, although I can't see them in the half light, officers and men, all laden up with equipment so heavily that they can barely walk. But they've got to carry with them the means by which they can fight the moment they land. The men who are sitting on the benches in the back of the glider are no doubt wondering whether the parachutists have succeeded in seizing the ground on which we're going to land. But if they're worried about it, they give no signs of it. Because a little while ago, when I moved back down the glider, I found the fellows at the end were singing. Above the roar of the air beating on the sides of, on the wooden sides of the glider, you can't hear their voices, except occasionally you catch a snatch of a song. Annie Laurie, the Mountains of Mourne, and I even heard them singing Land of Hope and Glory. The gliders which are coming in to support the paratroops are carrying vital cargoes, the senior staff unders, transport, signal equipment, and above all, the guns on which so much will depend in the morning. The moon is still hiding behind the clouds, but when I looked out through the perspex of the cockpit just now, we were passing right over some of the ships of the third wave of the assault forces. The ships which will carry British and American and Canadian troops to the shores of France in a few hours' time. But at the moment, those shores are still covered in darkness. What kind of a welcome we'll get, I don't know. We can only wait and see. We've just passed over the coast of France. And all around us along the coast, ACAC fire is going up, away to the right, away off to the left. But in front of us, there's nothing coming up at all. Except immediately, over about half right, where there's a fair amount of tracer streaming up from roughly the area where we're going to land. The moon is still hiding behind the clouds, but they've been pitching a fair amount of heavy stuff up away over near Le Havre. And where we've got a diversion going on with other bombers, and that has attracted most of their attention. I can see no sign of any of the other tug aircraft, no sign of any fires on the ground as a result of our bombing. Something very heavy burst just above us, well above us then, and brilliantly lit the cockpit. Now the ground below is still showing no signs of enemy activity. I can see away on our right the river, which is our main guide for coming into the landing zone, which is on the left of the river. And there now I can see the light which is to guide us in to our main landing zone.